We're back on Battle of the Blades, and now the real reason we're here. You know, every single skater wants to win the competition. That's a given when you bring together 16 ultra-competitive athletes such as we have. But beyond another win, there's a real reason why they signed on to do the battle. And the main reason is to give.
For me, here it's not about that. It's the greatest feeling to skate for someone and see the joy that it brings them.
It's a fantastic opportunity to rally together for unselfish reasons and really talk about some charities that we're passionate about.
The number one reason I agreed to do Battle 4 was to bring awareness to World Vision and Starting Strong. It's giving kids a healthy start and helping mothers right from the beginning. I have a 16-month-old, and I can't even imagine that I wouldn't be able to provide for him. He depends on me completely.
I'm skating for a SOM. It stands for Shirt Off My Back. We donate a full school uniform to a child to go to school in Africa. To see their faces light up and know they have an opportunity to go to school, I think that's what living's all about.
Amanda and I both actually skated for Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation.
I'd like to introduce my mother-in-law, Carol. Carol is really why I got started in this direction.
My mother-in-law's battling it right now, and she's healthy and strong and fighting this. And
my charity was the NHL Alumni and the Grassroots for Kids. Kids that can't afford to play hockey, all of a sudden they've got equipment. I can't say enough about them.
We skate for five Orphan Canada.
Orphan Canada was founded by a group of Canadian adoptive parents who traveled over to Russia and saw the conditions firsthand in the orphanages.
It's pretty sad. Young kids, they're not crying, but you can see the sadness in the eyes.
I skated for the MS Society of Canada. I was so proud to skate for them, and I just wish I could help even more.
I'm skating for the Megan's Wings Foundation, which is a charity that my brother founded. He lost his daughter at 9 years old of leukemia. We help families be there with their children through this terrible time in their lives.
You may say,
I'm very proud to skate for the Inner-City Children's Program in Edmonton.
That's it, dig away. Grind it up, uh-oh.
My whole life, I've always loved kids. All kids deserve the opportunity to start from the same place. Unfortunately, the reality is that it's not the case. We try to give them the opportunities that we're gonna be giving our kids.
I've chosen to skate for Humane Society of Kavarta Lakes. If you see anyone who works there, you can see the love for the animals they have. They're trying to bring love back into those animals' lives.
Purring right away, as soon as you get him in your hands.
I'm skating for the Montreal Canadiens Children's Foundation. We build outdoor rinks in deprived areas of Montreal to give kids a place to go.
I like that number. Look at that number.
And then I go visit some kids in the hospital. To have that interaction with them, it makes their day go by so much quickly, and I'm really proud of that.
I chose to skate for Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation. My mother, my aunt, and two of my friends were diagnosed with breast cancer. It's really important to give money to research so women can have better treatment after they're diagnosed.
In 1990, I sustained a broken neck. A player hit me from behind. I went headfirst in the boards.
My charity was Parachute. It's about injury prevention, spinal cord, and concussions.
Respect to the player you're playing against. You'll be a more successful athlete, and you'll be an even better person.
I was skating for the charity Autism Speaks. My youngest brother, David, is severely autistic. They help to provide that special attention to children with autism. I was really excited to work with the organization.
Say bye-bye to you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Kurt. Thank you, John. We are really thrilled to announce that as of tonight, Battle of the Blades has given $1 million plus to great Canadian charities right across the nation. But it doesn't even have to be a sum of money like that. Our Governor General, David Johnson, has inspired a wonderful new idea called My Giving Moment. Now, you may know David was a hockey player. He was the captain of his team at Harvard University, an amazing skater, known best for his creative assists. And David, this is your best yet. He's inviting all Canadians to assist others. You can go to mygivingmoment.ca and get all of the details. Let's hear it for the final two. We will obviously chat with the champion, but I wanted to give you each a little moment here to talk. Violetta, Jason, I'll start with you. Jason, on behalf of your partner, I know you skated, on behalf of your charities, you skated, a thought from you.
And the charity is a big reason why we're here. All the teams, that was a big reason we wanted to come out and support our charities. And we're all very proud to represent the charities we represent. I represent the Eastern Children's Program and V's the Humane Society of Quarter Lakes. And it was just great to come and to skate for them. And we had a lot of support from them, as all the guys did, from all their charities.
Scott.
First of all, I had so much fun watching all of these guys perform every week. It was an incredible experience. I can't say enough about Michael Siebert and Paul Martini. They made every day of practice fun for us out here, which was incredible. Amanda's been an absolute dream partner to skate with. So proud that the communities that have supported us, especially Collingwood, supporting us in raising some money for Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation.
By the way, happy birthday, Amanda. Let us get to the official and final results. Kurt, may I have the envelope, please? You are a secretary. Canada voted, and the winner, season 4, Battle of the Blades, Amanda Evora and Scott Thornton. All right. Violetta, Jason, thank you for an incredible 7 weeks. Let's get the winners in here. Where's the birthday girl? Amanda, I hate to steal you away. Scott, we'll run out of time if I don't give you... That's so great. Thanks, Shay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. You're going to be bawling anyway. To you. All right, Amanda Evora. This means a lot for Philippines, too. So let's start with you, Amanda. If you can, speak and tell us what being here means.
Right now, I'm just feeling a tremendous amount of gratitude. I want to thank Battle of the Blades for matching me up with Scott. I couldn't think of a better partner than him. to Sandra for giving me the call to be on the show, our coaches, Michael Siever and Paul Martini, for literally being the backbone behind us, and to CBC Insight Production. The best part about the show is the people. From the coaches, the judges, the drivers, hair, makeup, wardrobe, the camera crew.
Subtitles.
I have the utmost respect for you guys and what you stand for.
So sad, isn't it, winning? Let's bring in PJ Stock. Our judges have the trophy. This is, Scott, the Battle of the Blades trophy. I want to congratulate you. And, Scott, I'll hold a mic while you... I know you're strong enough to speak while you hold that. Just a quick thought now that you know you've got the $100,000 for the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation.
Absolutely, Ron. I mean, everybody here had a great charity to support, and it was really nice to watch the PACs tonight. I hope everybody finds it in their hearts to support charities.
Did you have a favorite routine out of 7 weeks? It's one thing I always wondered.
I think Bolero was my favorite routine of the whole competition.
Bolero, that was, you know, Paul Henderson in 72 in Canada, Bolero in the UK meant the very same. Congratulations. Why don't you go for a victory lap? Amanda Evora and Scott Thornton, season 4 champions. Congratulations, there's the official notice, Amanda and Scott. Did we thank makeup, hair, and wardrobe? I hope we did. Thank you, Kurt. You were terrific. To everybody behind the scenes, don't forget, 2 weeks from tonight, a very special celebration of excellence. Battle of the Blades is back in a fortnight. Sochi, the Olympic Games, 82 nights from tonight. The iconic hockey players and figure skaters set the scene. Till then, for now, from all of us, that's our little show. Good night.